Hello everyone, my name is Sakshi Sharma and today I am going to give a presentation on the topic Production Technology of Walnut. Before beginning, I would like to thank our course instructor Dr. Prashant Bakshi sir for giving me this opportunity. Given below are the contents of my presentation. Introduction. Walnut is the most important temperate nut fruit of the country. Walnut originates from walnut, an old English word for Welsh nut. It is grown in Jammu and Kashmir, Uttar Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh. It is also known from different names, akhrot in Hindi, doon in Kashmiri and gardgani in Yunani. The Greeks called walnuts kerion, meaning head, because the shell resembles a human skull and the walnut kernel itself looks like a brain. There are no regular orchards of walnuts in country because the existing planting are generally of seedling origin. The seedling trees attain giant size and start bearing nuts of variable size and shape after 10 to 15 years. Botanical description. Botanical name of walnut is Juglans regia. It belongs to kingdom Plantae, division Magnoliophyta, class Magnoliophyta, order Fagales, family Juglandaceae, genus Juglans. Overview of walnut. Botanical name is Juglans regia. Center of origin of walnut is Central Asia. Chromosome number is 2N equals to 32. Sex form is monoecious. Inflorescence is catkin. Growth curve is double sigmoid. Fruit type is nut. Edible part is cotyledon. Propagation is patch budding. Type of dichogamy is heterostyle. Chilling requirement is around 200 to 800 hours. Nature of fruit is non-climacteric, nature of plant is deciduous and 10 to 40 meter tall. It gives energy around 687 calories, mode of pollination is cross-pollination, mechanism of pollination is anemophilous, that is through wind, and species are butternut and heartnut. Now areas of cultivation of walnut. Walnut is grown mainly in Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Arunachal Pradesh. Jammu and Kashmir is the major walnut producing state of the country. The important districts of Jammu and Kashmir for walnut production are Anantnag, Pulwama, Kupwara, Budgam, Baramulla, Srinagar, Doda, Poonch and Udhampur. Now ecological requirements. Altitude. Walnut grows in temperate regions between the altitude of 900 to 3500 meter above sea level. Temperature. It is highly sensitive to the extremes of winter and summer temperatures. Temperature of even 2 or 3 degrees Celsius below freezing point kills leaves, shoots and flowers and thus resulting in crop failure. Temperature above 38 degrees Celsius results in sunburning of hulls and shriveled kernels. Rainfall. It requires 760 to 800 mm rainfall. To obtain higher yield, avoid planting walnut in drought-prone areas. Soil. A well-drained, deep loam soil containing an abundance of organic matter is most suitable for walnut cultivation. A soil depth of 2 to 3 meter give the best results because walnut roots penetrates up to a depth of about 3 meter. It requires a soil pH of neutral range, that is 6.5 to 7. Now varieties of walnut grown in India. Walnut varieties developed throughout the world are seedling selection. A large number of varieties introduced from abroad or selected from indigenous material in India include exotic cultivars like Lake English, Kolbe Blackmore, Turtle 16, Turtle 31, Nelson, Orth, Ser and Natra Atiro, which are doing well under Himachal Pradesh conditions. In Himachal Pradesh, Gobind, Rupa, Ratna, Pratap and Scholding varieties of walnut are grown. In Jammu and Kashmir, Hamadan, Suleiman, CITH walnut, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10 varieties of walnut are grown. In Uttarakhand, Charata number 2, 4, 6, 13 and 14 varieties of walnut are grown. Hamadan, trees are semi-dwarf, exhibit terminal or lateral bearing, medium nut weight is 14 grams, large, strong, good seal and rough texture nuts, medium kernel weight is 7.6 grams with kernel recovery 54%. It is developed and released by Scost Kashmir, Srinagar in 2001. Chandler, trees are moderately vigorous, exhibit lateral bearing, Medium nut weight is 13.2 grams and it is oval in shape. Shell is smooth, light in color, and medium kernel weight is 6.5 grams with kernel recovery 49%. Kernels are extra light in color and it is compatible pollinizers, which is used for Cisco, Frankfurt and Fernet varieties of walnut. Frankfurt. Trees are vigorous, exhibit terminal bearing, medium nut weight is 11 grams, medium thin shell with good seal, medium kernel weight is 5.5 grams. Hartley. Trees are large, exhibit terminal bearing and moderate yield. Medium nut weight is 14.3 grams and it has an attractive shape. Medium kernel weight is 6.5 grams with kernel recovery 45%. And it is light in color and it is easy to remove kernel halves. Now, varieties of walnut which are introduced by CITH Srinagar, that is Central Institute of Temperate Horticulture. CITH Walnut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. These are the varieties of walnut which are introduced by Central Institute of Temperate Horticulture, Srinagar. Now, propagation. First is seed propagation. Healthy and disease-free seeds should be selected for sowing. They may be sown in lines 50 cm apart and the seed-to-seed distance should be kept at 25 cm. Sowing is done during mid-November to mid-January depending on the altitude and temperature. It is advisable to avoid propagation by seed because the plants which are grown by this method take a very long time, that is 10 to 12 years to begin fruiting, and the plant characteristics may also not be true to type. Second is grafting. Grafting is more difficult in walnut than most fruit and nut crops. There is bleeding of sap flow which occurs mainly due to root pressure. If sap comes up under the tape after grafting, it may kill the graft. This bleeding can be controlled by cutting off the rootstock 2 to 3 inches above the site for grafting about 2 weeks before grafting, or by making cuts in the rootstock through the bark and into wood as low as possible below the graft. Bleeding is found more when there is a large fluctuation in temperature. Extreme cold or heat retards the healing of graft union. Efficient methods for grafting in walnut are wedge and whip methods. The most suitable time for walnut grafting is last week of February to mid-March. Third is patch budding. Patch budding is generally practiced to propagate walnut plants vegetatively. The best period for budding is May to June. Scion should always be selected from the tree which has already started fruiting. Now, layout and planting orchard. Lay out the walnut orchards in skewer or quincunx design in gentle slope and flat valley. Use contour planting for hilly and steep slope. Space the plants depending on the tree type and vigor. For small and compact tree, use initial spacing of 5 meter into 5 meter and adjust this to 10 meter into 10 meter at maturity for high density planting. For highly fruitful lateral bearing but vigorous cultivars and terminal bearing vigorous cultivars, maintain an initial spacing of 6 meter into 6 meter and then finally adjust to 12 meter into 12 meter. When pollinizers are required, place them in permanent position to avoid their elimination during the temporary tree removal. Every 8 row, a pollinizer variety is planted perpendicular to the usual direction of the wind. After layout, pit digging should be done well in advance for soil solarization. Dig a pit 1 meter deep and 1 meter in diameter. Keep the top surface soil from the subsoil separate. Fill the pit with mixture of rotten FYM and top surface soil at the ratio of 1:2. Now is the manures and fertilizers. Following guide shows the indicative amount of NPK for walnut. Walnut trees that are of 1 year require 100 g of nitrogen per plant, 50 g of phosphorus per plant and 50 g of potash per plant. So, different ages of walnut trees require different amounts of NPK per plant. Next is irrigation. Watering is very essential for the establishment of grafts and young plants. When the trees start bearing, irrigation should be given from the time of fruit set till its maturity to reduce the fruit drop and for better filling of nuts. When the trees are grown under rain-fed conditions and common irrigation systems followed are flood, furrow, sprinkler and drip irrigation. Training and pruning. Modified central ladder system is most ideal for training since it provides very good strength to its framework. Trees should be trained on a single stem up to 1 to 2 meter on which 5 to 6 scaffold branches should be retained at almost uniform distance spirally. Excess buds should be pinched during first year. Pruning is not being practiced in our country as almost entire population or plantation is of seedling origin, attaining giant size which makes pruning in late years almost impossible. However, with grafted plants, pruning is practicable which can help increase the productivity and improve the quality. Trees of seedling origin receive some kind of pruning while harvesting by thrashing the limbs with wooden poles. Flowering. Walnut plants are monoecious, that is, they have separate pistillate, that is female, and staminate, that is male. So these are different male and female part of walnut flowers. Bearing. Age of commercial bearing is 6 to 10 years. Tree density at full production is 75 to 125 trees per hectare. Peaches are often interplanted for first 10 to 15 years. Most of the walnut plantation are terminal bearing and take long time to first flowering and fruiting. Some rare walnut trees are lateral bearing, that is a few buds behind the terminal on the new growth have female flowers too. Terminal bearing cultivars have long gestation period and low productivity. Then is harvesting and post-harvest management. Walnuts are usually harvested when the hull color changes from green to yellowish with cracks or when splitting starts at suture from pedicel end. Nuts should be harvested at PTB stage when packing tissue turns brown. For better nut recovery, the orchard floor should be cleaned and tarpaulin or polythene sheets may be spread on the floor beneath trees prior to knocking off the nuts. After harvesting, nuts should be properly dehulled, washed and dried. In case nuts are not dried properly, there is every apprehension of mold development which impairs the quality of the fruit. In Kashmir, walnuts are harvested in September. This is harvesting and dehulling of walnut. Next is yield. Fully grown walnut trees produces as high as 125 to 150 kg nuts. However, an average yield of 40 to 50 kg of nuts can be obtained per one walnut tree. Again, the yield depends on the cultivar and farm management practices. Second is pests and diseases. Codling mouth. It attacks early blooming walnut. To escape this, use pheromone traps during May month and spray diazinon or carbaryl. Second is walnut husk fly. It damages only mid and late season cultivars and we will feed on kernel causing premature fruit drop. To escape this, spray carbaryl twice at 7 days interval. Next is walnut blight. Infection occurs right from early spring to summer. Nut drop, shrivels and discoloration occurs. Rainfall, dew, fog and sprinkler irrigation aggravate. To escape this, spray Bordeaux mixture at 10 days interval on opening of first female flower. Next is anthracnose. It attacks leaves, young shoot and fruit. It destroys leaves, fallen leaves and to escape this, spray with Zenab or Captain. Next is walnut canker or dieback. It causes swollen or sunken areas of various sizes, rupture the bark of branches and trunk. To escape this, apply paste of copper oxychloride on diseased portion and foliar spray. Next is black line. Poor terminal growth, die back, drooping leaves, profuse suckering and small holes on the bark at graft union occurs in Persian walnut. This is due to virus movement from Persian walnut scion to Juglans hindsii or paradox, which are hypersensitive action occur, forming a black line of the infected cells at the graft union. Virus dies at the union and stalk remains virus-free. It is transmitted by mechanical inoculation, grafting, pollen and nematodes. Now is nutritional value of walnut. Walnuts are excellent sources of protein. It contains 14% to 20% proteins. They are excellent source of fats. It contains 60 to 70% of fats. Walnuts are rich in omega-3, vitamin B and E, fibers and some trace elements. Walnuts have high energetic values. They are highly recommended to athletes. Immature fruits are rich in ascorbic acid and they contain antioxidants. Now, uses of walnut. Walnut kernels are used for dessert purposes and confectionery and for extraction of oil and as dry fruit. Immature fruits are used for making pickles, chutneys, juice and syrups. Walnut oil is used for edible purposes, artist oil colors, varnishes and soap making. Walnut shell flour is used as ingredient in battery cases, molding resin form, industrial tile and as insecticide spreader. Walnut timber is used for furniture, carving and making butts of guns. Now is health benefits of walnut. It lowers cholesterol, it reduces inflammation, it boosts immunity, it helps in weight loss, it strengthens hair. Anti-aging properties are present in walnut and it helps in cancer prevention. Life is a walnut, short and hard, but once you know the secret to crack it, it's all sweet and beautiful and gross. So that is all about production technology of walnut. Thank you very much.